Div and span tags for grouping. See, in HTML, grouping is going to be very important, especially when we want to have common set of style properties or maybe a particular group of tags or a section of a page. We would like to do some kind of programming in JavaScript. So for grouping, there are two tags available. One is a div tag and the other is the span tag. Div tag, we say, is a block level tag. It is going to identify a block. Whereas span is an inline tag. It is going to identify a section of a page without providing any break before and after. Obviously, both of these tags by themselves do not provide any visual change unless we apply that using cascading style sheets, and of course that's what we are going to cover in the subsequent course of CSS. But here I would like to surely demonstrate how a div tag can be used in a HTML page or how a span tag can be used in a HTML page. So let us say this is a block. Now this particular block, imagine we would like to identify with a tag, so we can give div and this whole block will put it inside. And let us say like this, we would have another block. We might go for multiple blocks. So let's say grouping.html, right click, view in browser, and we have three different blocks here. Advantage is for each one of them we can give a different style. And let us say we can give a different color. I say color is equal to red, and let us say background color we give it as maybe yellow. So we are now giving a style attributes for only the second block, and only that second block has changed its color. So like this, yes, but what you have to notice, the first block is this, second block is this, and third block is this. Of course, for every div we also have the ability to give width. We can say this is what is the width, maybe 300 pixels, and we can say this is the height. Maybe so let's say 400 pixels. Obviously, this we are going to elaborate more in CSS. But right now, I want you to understand the importance of div. It is a block. Reduce it to 200. Save it, come back, and this is 200. But span doesn't work like this. Span is little different. So I give here HR and I'll say this is a long paragraph to explain about the span tag. Now let us say paragraph to explain is what I want to give a different background color, or I want to do different formatting, but at the same time I want to ensure that it does not break. It should be in continuous. So if I'm using div here, you see the impact. It will become, save this, come back, refresh. If you use div, it becomes three different blocks, one before, and the div is one block, and one after. But I'll now change this to span and see the impact. Just change it to span, come back, refresh, and it will be continuous. Advantage is simple. Here for this particular section alone, we can give a different color. We can give different set of style properties for that section alone. Save this file, come back and refresh. Oh, this should be style, and you see paragraph is equal to explain. So div divides and creates blocks. Span spans, it does not create blocks. Both of them we can give some ID if needed, div1, and in JavaScript later we are going to again learn we can program that div, and same is the case here, we can give some ID, and you can use this ID further for programming that section of the paragraph. So yes, span spans and div divides. So div is a block level tag which plays a big role in grouping various other HTML tags and applying CSS on a group of elements. So see, there are different group of elements. Together for all of them, a common set of style properties provided. That's what is div. So I copy here, paste, save, come back, refresh, and you see this is the first group. Likewise, span does not do any kind of grouping. I mean, it does grouping, but it does not break. It goes as inline element, and it is used to group inline elements in the HTML document. This tag also does not provide any visual change. It doesn't provide any kind of visual change on the block, but has meaning when it is used with CSS. So two very, very, very important tags. We have put the foundation today. And whenever we will develop advanced websites, today websites we call it as responsive websites, websites which provide content properly in not only desktop but consistently the same content is properly also rendered in tablets and mobile devices, the grouping is going to play a very major role. So in those kind of cases, yes, span tags and div tags are going to be very, very, very important. But as of now, this is what we should know with span and div in context of HTML.